in this transition where we do see light at the end of the tunnel, where there is a ray of optimism and hopefulness that this too shall pass, it's also perhaps the most difficult and challenging phase of all. But this phase is one where science, where public health, not politics, must be the guide. We have a parameter, we have a framework that will guide our decision making, and will be predicated on the ability to do six things. The most important framework is our capacity to expand our testing, to appropriately address the tracing and tracking of individuals, the isolation and the quarantine of individuals using technology and using a workforce that needs to be trained. The second phase is maintaining our vigilance on protecting the most vulnerable populations in the state of California from infection and spread. Number three is addressing again the ongoing needs of our hospital and alternative care delivery system to meet the needs of potential surges as we adopt new strategies, as we loosen the stay-at-home orders, ultimately and eventually the prospect of increase infections and spreads. We need to make sure that that infrastructure is protected and to make sure that those assets are well prepared. The fourth frame is to continue the work that we've been doing on a weekly basis, and that is to engage academia, to engage our research partners, to engage those that are on the front lines, and they happen disproportionately to be here in California, companies like Gilead, companies like Genentech, incredible operations of support that are coming from our hospital systems, UCs, Stanford, USCs, Scripps, and others, including our national labs, to make sure that we're really advancing and continuing to promote more protocols on therapeutics, which are profoundly important as we bridge ultimately towards the herd immunity and the vaccine. Number five is the incredible importance of redrawing our floor plans. And that is quite literally a responsibility if we are moving into a next phase of our businesses so that we can practice safe physical distancing within the premise of a business, within and around a school site and facilities, large and small, public and private, all throughout the state of California. So quite literal strategies, guidelines, and expectations on what physical distancing would look like within those facilities, not just broadly out on the streets, our parks, playgrounds, and in our coastlines. And finally, our capacity always to turn on that faucet again and reinstate more vigorous controls. And that's just a process that will perhaps be the most challenging if indeed we lean in, but we have to then lean back out as we toggle from stricter to looser interventions, back and forth. As things change, as data comes in, as health concerns make themselves real in terms of that data, or at least more obvious, our capacity to pull you back in and to encourage people to advance the social distancing, the stay at home and physical distancing that has gotten us to this point today. And so that's the framework. Those are the six frames of focus that we will monitor and that we will process as we make the determination through this process of architecting a next phase in this pandemic.